Hello, my name's William. William Shakespeare.
Do you want to read a sonnet?
I could read about 1.5 billion of these. Mama always said life was like a book of sonnets. You never know what you're gonna read. That looks like a good book. I bet you could read that book all day and never get bored. My mama said you could tell a lot about a person by the books they read. Where they're going, where they've been, where they were, where they will be. I bet if I think real hard, I could remember my first book.
My mama said it was my magic book. She said it would take me anywhere. And that book led to other new books that taught me of far-off lands, different cultures, and war heroes. Speaking of which, my mama told me about my papa's grandpa's grandpa's grandpa, or something like that. He was a hero in this war about flowers. They called it the War of the Roses. So I don't know why anyone would want flowers that bad.
Now those books got me a-thinking. Maybe I could write something like that. So I started writing. Now at that point, I was getting ready to start my schooling.
Now my teachers, they said I showed promise.
Oh, William, you're showing promise, son.
Now I don't know about that. I didn't make no promises to nobody. I just wrote because I liked it. And I wrote to impress Anne. She was the most beautiful thing I have ever seen. She liked my writing.
I like your writing, William.
And I liked her. She was my most special friend. From that point on, we were like peas and carrots.
It's stupid!
Now some people, they didn't like my writing.
What's your writing? I don't like it.
A sonnet.
A bonnet? Why are you writing a bonnet? Cause you're stupid.
Stupid is stupid, right?
Whatever, stupid. Let's get 'em.
Keep throwing rocks.
Right, William.
From that point on, wherever I was going, I was writing. I wrote during school, after school, and while eating. I even wrote in my sleep. Sometimes I would write with a number 2 quill while going number 1. Or a number 1 quill while going number 2.
I wrote everywhere. Now, I never thought writing would take me anywhere, but it did.
I joined and became a leading member of this group that called themselves the Lord Chamberlain's Men. Now, I've never knew no Lord Chamberlain, but that's okay. I got to write and act, shoot, I even got to direct a little bit.
That's good, everybody. Now with a little more intensity.
Whatever happened to Anne?
Well, we got married, and we had three beautiful children. And we still together like peas and carrots.
Till one day.
Were he not Romeo called, retain that dear perfection which he owes without that title.
My papa's sick.
My papa will see ya.
Hello, William.
Papa, you sick?
It's my time, William. It's just my time.
But it's only 3:30. Your soap's aren't on till 4. Are you gonna make it?
I don't think so, William. Goodbye, William.
Papa! No!
That was the day before yesterday. I miss my papa. So I'm writing a play about him, thinking about calling it Hamlet. He really liked those individually packed ham omelets. They were called Hamlets. Having a bit of a writer's block, though. Don't know where to go from here.
These help me think. They're my brain food.
Oh, how I love York peppermint patties. Alas, poor York peppermint patty, a sweet chocolatey candy of infinite jest and most excellent fancy.
That sounds good. You should put that in your play.
Oh, I think I will. Thank you, sir. What's your name?
I'm Francis Bacon.
Thank you, Mr. Bacon. Thank you.